Open Central Crossing. My name's Abraham, and we got the news for you today. Ms. Russell and Ms. Rendell, thank you, and we're glad to have you here with us today. Let's find out what's popping with the weather. Daisha, what's up?
Yes, it is nice of you to be with us. Today's weather will be a high of 55 degrees and a low of 35, with wind speeds of 10 miles per hour. Spring will be here soon, we hope. In the meantime, though, we still have our COVID school. Ms. Russell, do you have some tips for us?
I sure do. Today, we are here to give you 12 mental health tips. The first tip, which hopefully you've already done, is to establish a routine. This includes structure, a daily routine, and a sleep schedule. Second tip is to stay active and exercise. Remember, even walking is exercise, which creates endorphins in our brains, which makes us feel happier. Tip number three is to go outside. Today is a perfect day for that. Sunlight also can improve your mood. Tip number four is to do your schoolwork. We only have a few weeks left. This helps you stay mentally active, and believe it or not, you will feel better if you like to have the feeling of accomplishment. Please check your cohort classrooms with some additional tips.
Wow. Thanks, Mrs. Russell. This is very helpful. Now, we have news for all of you. Final exams have been moved up a week for all grade levels. They are May 19th through the 22nd. The teachers will be individually sharing specifics about their class. So make sure you are tuned in to Google Classroom, your cohort classroom, and your email. And I believe Daisha has some senior news.
Yes, I do. First, yesterday was senior pickup for caps and gowns. If you missed out on that, please call the school. Next, seniors, you have your drive-by graduation, May 23rd, and then your virtual graduation is May 30th. Make sure you are checking Google Classroom and your email for more information.
And that goes for all of us. We've all got to stay in touch via classroom and email. Remember, the AP exams have begun. Good luck to all of you taking those exams over the next few weeks. And for all of us, Ms. Russell is here with some more tips.
Thank you. Tip number five is to stay organized, just like you should if you were here at school. A cluttered room is equal to a cluttered mind. Tip number six is to do something creative. Listen to music, cook, do someone else's makeup, take a picture, other things that you can think of. Tip number seven is to actually keep a journal. What a great thing to have years down the road regarding this whole experience that we've been through. Tip number eight is to reach out to others. Communicate with your family via email, text, FaceTime, Zoom. There's so many different ways.
Thanks, Ms. Fairs. One way we can reach out is through, food. We've provided a variety of quarantine food ideas. Well, today we've got Jayana in the house with a great family food idea.
Hi, Central Crossing News. This is Jayana and my family. Mama, this is my grandma.
Hi.
And today we're making homemade pizzas. So,
right now,
we had our little baby chef make pizzas, and she's going to show you step by step how to start your pizza.
So first, you're going to spread vegetable oil on your pizza crust, like how. You can either use a knife, a spoon, whatever. Secondly, you're going to add the pizza sauce on the pizza by placing it in a ladle, and then using that ladle, knife, spoon, or whatever, to start spreading the pizza sauce around on your pizza. Now thirdly, you're going to start adding cheese, as much cheese as you want on your pizza, depending if you're a cheesy person or not so cheesy person. You're just going to grab a handful and start spreading it around as you see she's doing right now. As you see now, when you finish putting a desired amount of toppings and cheese on your pizza, you set your pizza in the oven on a heat of 350 for 10 to 12 minutes. And that, Central Crossing, is how you make your own handmade pizzas from home. Now, as you see these pictures here, here are the little final results of our pizzas before we put them in our oven. Thank you for watching and enjoy the rest of your day.
Thanks, Jayana. That pizza looked amazing. And what? Who doesn't like pizza? Well, I'm here with some more tips for you. Tip number nine is to eat healthy. So what does pizza have to do with being healthy? Well, of course, you could have a salad, throw in some veggies, maybe drink a little milk with your pizza. I don't put pineapple on my pizza, but maybe you could sneak some fruit in that way. Tip number 10 is to listen to music. Those of you that know me well know that I love a good song and I love music. Music can help us energize, music can help us de-stress. Find some of your favorite songs, kick back, relax, and listen to some good music. Of course, we've got a few more tips. Tip number 11 is to limit your news watching. We don't mean the school news because we're going to keep it short and sweet. But remember that national news, sometimes that can be a little overwhelming. So take a break from it once in a while. Turn it off so you don't feel quite so anxious. And last but not number and least is tip number 12. Remember that this will not last forever. Staying positive does not mean that things will turn out okay. Rather, it is knowing that you will be okay no matter how things turn out. So Comets, stay positive, stay strong, because of course, that's the Comet way.
Thanks, Ms. Rendell. You all have such good ideas. We appreciate how you take care of us, Comets. Sophia from our news team also has some ideas. Take a look at this.
Hi, I'm Sophie, and here's a list of things that you can do to stay sane during quarantine. The first thing that you can do is play some games with your family.
Hey Josh, you want to play a card game?
No.
Oh. Dad, do you want to play a card game?
No.
Dang.
Okay, so as you can see, that didn't really work out as I wanted it to. However, you can find some friends to do it with you.
Bro, are you cheating?
And then I found out that Biscuit was cheating and I was very upset and I bisquit.
Another thing that you can do is chores. And then when you realize how absolutely ridiculous that is, you can have a guitar solo. Until your dad comes back from downstairs and then you have to go back to sweeping. The next thing you can do is you can cut your grass with a pair of scissors. Now I know it sounds ridiculous, but by the end of it, it's quite a satisfying feeling. Now that sports are canceled, you can play it in your own home. Hi, me.
Sophia!
Yeah, maybe don't do that one. Next, you can go on a run.
Put the mail's here. Spicy. Is it recorded? It's really cold. Not recommended. Not today.
Okay, so I'll admit it. When I did that, it was freezing outside. But now that it's beautiful, you can go on a run. You can try to learn the guitar that you forced your parents to buy you when you were little because you thought that it wouldn't take any effort at all to learn it. But it turns out it does. And you can now learn the guitar. Or you can learn the piano. It's pretty fun. Can you see how intently I'm focusing on playing not actual chords? Pretty amazing. Next, you can do some yoga. It's great for the mind and for the body. Ninja karate things. You can also play with chalk. It's actually a lot of fun. It kind of sounded ridiculous when somebody told me that I should try it, but I did, and I actually turned out to have a great time.
Hey. Didn't want no one to hold you. What does that mean? And you said, ain't nothing gonna break my stride.
Clip here, you can see me really like focusing down and taking it seriously, which is pretty ironic considering that the outcome turned out to be kind of trashy.
Ain't nothing gonna break my stride. Nobody gonna slow.
But nevertheless, I had a great time doing it, so 10 out of 10, you should do it. Do it now. Now that it's beautiful outside, you can go and read a book. It was a lot of fun.
This guy, like, two blocks down is mowing his lawn, and I can hear it clear as day. Ridiculo.
You can also try things that you've always wanted to try. So this is my first time ever doing a cartwheel in about 11 years. And then, as you can see, that failed quite miserably, and then I started doing this weird thing, and then I stopped. I know that social distancing is hard for a lot of people. It's hard for everybody. But if we just stick through it for another couple of weeks, it'll all be over. So stay inside and social distance. Well, thanks for watching. Be sure to click that subscribe button and punch that bell notification. If you want to, I won't force you. Have a good day.
Wow. Sophia, that was fun. Great show today. Guys, Ms. Russell, Ms. Rendell, thanks for being with us. We appreciate all of your advice. Central, we miss you. Take care of yourselves. But that's it for today.
Have a quarantine Tuesday.
Have a beautiful Tuesday. Get outside and soak up some vitamin D.
Not saying goodbye, but instead I'll say see you soon. Take care, guys.
See you later.